Hello, good morning everyone. I hope you all are kicking in your life. Although most of you are familiar with me, but those who are joining the class from today, let me introduce myself. I am Vivek Singh, TGT Maths from Soniya International School, Majhra Paschim. Today we will see the first chapter of class 10th in the mathematics, real number. I hope that you all are with pen and pencils. So let's start the class. All the best, be positive and take the class seriously, because nowadays circumstances are not very good. The whole country, although you can say that the whole world is fighting against the corona, it is a very difficult to conduct a classroom scenario at least for a month. So our school has decided to provide you regular classes in the terms of e-classes. So dear students, today we are going to start real number. It is a very relevant to tell you a story regarding this chapter. Have you ever touched the ghost or you hugged the ghost? Most of you are laughing. Okay, no, never. Because what is ghost? Ghost is an imaginary character. You can't touch it. You can't hug it. So the things which we cannot see or put scientifically anywhere where we want, these things are called imaginary. Similarly, numbers are of two types, real numbers and imaginary numbers. From the real classes, you all know that numbers are represented on the number line, whether they are natural number, whole number or integers. We can put all the integers, whole number and natural number on the number lines. So to judge a number, whether it is a real or imaginary, what the things we have to choose? We have to choose number line. The number which can be represented on the number line are belongs to the real number, because they exist. And the numbers which cannot be expressed on number line, they are known as imaginary number. The details of imaginary number is out of your syllabus. You will read it in class 11th and 12th. So now we will come to our topic. Real number are of two types. Real numbers are of two types. Rational and irrational. Rational numbers and irrational numbers. Till now, you know about the real number. Real numbers are of two types, rational and irrational. The number, those are represented on the number line, are known as real number, and real number are of two types, rational and irrational. All the numbers known by everyone, natural number, whole number and integers. All the counting numbers are known as natural number, starts from 1, 2 and ends at the infinity. Whereas whole number starts from 0, so on, ends up to the infinity. What are integers? Integers are natural number with positive and negative both the signs. So integers are plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, plus minus 4, up to infinity. But here you see two integers, positive integers and negative integers. They are joined with a number which is known as 0. So what is 0? 0 is the interjection between positive and negative integers. 0 has only number which has no sign, neither positive nor negative. Again, watch this clearly. 1, 2, 3, 100, 500, infinity, and it starts from 0. So every natural number is the part of whole number, or you can say that all the natural numbers belong to the whole number, but all the whole numbers are not natural number. This is a very important question and very important line. Regarding this point, you will see some MCQs in the board examinations. Integers. Integers are positive as well as negative, and 0 is the intersection between positive and negative integers. 0 is the only numeral which has no sign, neither positive nor negative. Then what is natural number? All the and one more number you have learned from class 4, fractional number. Everyone knows the capital of India. What is the capital of India? Yes, yes, New Delhi. New Delhi is the capital of India. So N for New and D for Delhi. Any number which has numerator and denominator are known as fractional number. This is a confusion among not only among the students but few teachers. We also confused about fractional number and rational number. Fractional numbers are not rational number. Sometimes they both may be equal, but it is not true. There is a slight difference between fractional number and rational number. I will clear. Rational numbers. By the definition, any number which can be expressed in the form of P upon Q, or you can say that A upon B, whatever the variable, you are free to choose it. Any number which can be expressed in the form of P upon Q, here Q is not equal to 0 and P comma Q are co-primes, are called rational number. This is the definition. But what if definition tells you? That is the important. Any number which is of the form of P upon Q, where P and Q both are the integers, and integers are of two types, positive and negative. P and Q both will be positive, both may be negative, one positive and one negative. So there are total four options to choosing P and Q. P may be positive, Q negative, P negative, Q also negative, both are positive. So in this way, you can choose like four ways. P and Q are the integers, but Q never equals to 0. Because when Q becomes 0, the whole values become infinity, which is not true by the definition of rational number. Co-primes. I am taking two numbers, 4 upon 6. We have two numbers. Here the value of P, 4. The value of Q, 6. You write all the factors of P as well as all the factors of Q. And what are factors? Factors are the number which divided the given number exactly without leaving any remainder. So 1, 2 and 4. 4 is divisible by 3 numbers, and those 3 numbers are known as the factor of 4. So 4 has 3 factors, 1, 2 and 4. Where 6 has 4 factors, 1, 2, 3 and 6. So what are the common factors? What are the common factors between 4 and 6? 1 and 2. The common factors are 1 and 2. The word co-primes means the common factor between the given number is only 1. Is only 1. That is the heart of this chapter. If you understood this, half of the work is done. All the factors are 4, all the factors are 6, common factor 1 and 2. Other than 1, it has one more common factor, that is 2. So these two numbers are not co-primes. These two numbers are not co-primes. primes. And if the numbers are not two primes, therefore 4 upon 6 is not a rational number. I hope that now it is clear. Further, we can learn more about this point. Now reduce it to the lowest term. Both are divisible by 2. Then it is known as rational number. So what type of number 4 upon 6 is? 4 upon 6 is a fractional number. That is the thing which I was told to you earlier, just 5 minutes ago. Fractional number and rational numbers are the different. But when fractional number, listen what I am saying. But when fractional number is converted into its lowest term, it will change into rational number. That is the difference between fractional number and rational number. In fractional number, they have the common factors, but in rational numbers, they are always coprime. Take some examples. 2 upon 5, 11 upon 7, 22 upon 19. These are our rational numbers, and we can express it later. I will show you how you will represent the given rational number on the number line. Irrational number. Just reverse the definition. The definition you came to know, you just reverse it. Any number which cannot be expressed in the form of P upon Q are known as irrational number. This is a number line 0, 1, 2. What is 1? 1 may be written as 1 upon 1, whereas 2 is written as 2 upon 1. So this number is a rational number, and this number is also a rational number. So all the natural numbers and all the whole numbers and all the integers are rational numbers. All the natural numbers, all the whole numbers, and all the integers, they are the part of rational number. But between two rational numbers, what are 1 and 2? What is this? This is a line. And both 1 and 2 are lying on the line, so they are the point. And we all know that 1 and 2, how many points are lying between them? Infinitely many. Infinitely many. And these infinitely many points are representing the irrational number. So we have infinitely many irrational numbers between the two given rational numbers. Later we will discuss some applications of the taught topics. In class 9, you have heard about the decimal representation of rational number. There are three types of decimal numbers only. By example, we will see 4 upon 5 first, take 3 decimal numbers, 17 upon 2 and 17 upon 3. We have 3 fractional numbers, or you can say that rational numbers. So after watching their decimal representation, what we can conclude? 4 upon 5, that means 0.8. 17 upon 2, it means 8.5. 17 upon 3, 5, 6, 6, and so on. In the first and second example, what are these? The portion which lies towards the left of decimal and the portion which lies towards the right of decimal, both are known. So they are the end points. When we know the end points of decimal representation, they are called terminating decimals. Terminating decimals means when we know about the whole terminals of the decimal representation, then it is a terminating decimal. And you see here 4 and 5 both are proprimes. So terminating decimals are rational number. Second example is also terminating decimal. So it is a rational number. Whereas in the third example 17 upon 3, when we divide 17 by 3, what is our result? Our result is 5.66666. So it will not end. It will not end. So what we will say about this? This is a non-terminating decimal representation. Non-terminating decimal representation. But one very important thing. The numbers are repeating again and again. 6, 6, 6, 6. So it is called non-terminating repeating decimal, or say reoccurring decimal. Non-terminating repeating decimal. Non-terminating repeating decimal is also in the form of rational number, because numerator and denominator both are integers and the common factor between 17 and 3 is 1. So it is also a rational number. By watching carefully the decimal representation of any given number, if the decimal representation is terminating or non-terminating repeating decimal, then such type of decimal representation are included in rational number. Rational numbers in the form of decimal representation, terminating decimal and non-terminating reoccurring decimal numbers are included in rational numbers. So what do you say about irrational number? Irrational numbers. The third type of decimal representation is non-terminating, non-repeating decimal numbers are irrational numbers. Please you note down so that I can give you the example of non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. The fourth example is 13 upon 9. Here the value of P is 13. Value of Q is 9. Number is represented in the form of P upon Q. So check whether it is a terminating or non-terminating decimal. It is a rational or irrational. Divide 4, 40, 13, 9, 4, 40, 9, 4, 0. 36. 9 for the 36. 4. 9 for the 36. It is an also example of rational number. Let me think how to choose an example of non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. 16 upon 7. 16 upon 7. 7 to the 14. Then 0.2. 20. 7 to the 14. 6. 60. 7 8 jar 56, 4 40, 7 5 jar 35, 5 50, 7 7 jar 49, 1 10, 7 1 jar 7, 3 30, 7 4 jar 28, 2 20. So, what is this? This is non terminating, non repeating. Neither we are getting the terminals nor we are finding the repeating numbers. So, it is non terminating, non repeating decimal. And hence it is an irrational number. So in the form of decimal representation, there are three types of number and all types are taught by me today. So we will meet with your queries in the tomorrow's classes. Revise it and pick your doubts and send it to the given email. We will give you the solution. Thank you. Thank you for the classes. Vivek is signing off.